at my highest. I'ma rip this shit till my bones.
What's up, guys? The veins popping, panty dropping, blast double, and stay flexing. Deep Dorenzo here, and it's just another day in the Animal Kingdom. All right, so today we're going over how to conventional deadlift. You can walk there. And so I'm gonna show you the difference between a conventional, or no, I'm sorry, we're going over sumo deadlift. We did conventional last time, so I'm gonna go over the differences of sumo rather than conventional. All right, so start off from the front angle. Alright, so whereas conventional, you have your feet kind of shoulder width, with sumo, you're going to bring your feet out, so you're kind of making like an A. So usually you'll have rings on the bar, and your pinky toe kind of wants to be aligned with that. Now same thing with conventional, hips back, hands down. The only thing different about sumo, you get a little wider. Like it's going to be easier to lock out harder off the ground. Alright, you go double overs, go over under, it's all up to you. One big thing I really want to stress is core stability and core strength. So here, right before you go, take a big deep breath. Flex that core like someone's about to punch you. From here, just like conventional, pull that slack out of the bar. You see how my butt only gets this low? I'm going to pull the slack out and get my butt lower. Think about breaking the bar, push your chest through. Track those lats, straight up. All right, now I'll switch over to side angle. All right. A wide stance, bar over midfoot. Pull that slack over the bar. Push your chest through, shoulders back, straight up, hips through.
This is going to be a little more stress on your inner thigh rather than conventional because of how much the legs are spread out. So it's going to be a lot more stress in the groin. But depending on what your goals are, you should probably try to switch it up. Get a little bit of both in. The other thing about this is it's going to be a lot easier for your back to want to arch back. So I'm sure you guys have all seen the famous videos of Ronnie Coleman kind of arching back. That is a very bad technique. Now, Ronnie Coleman, given with Ronnie Coleman, but as soon as you start arching back, so you gotta remember the weight is pulling you straight down. So once you start arching back, now it's pulling your spine straight down in an arch back position, that it should not be doing that, all right? So that is a good key thing to make sure. Make sure to brace your core, which is a very big thing that I don't think I went over in conventional. So always take a big deep breath, hold that breath in, contract that core, and don't let it out till about you're 75% through the lift already, all right? There's really not too much difference, it's more the stance is really different and which one's easier off the ground. Like I said, conventional is gonna be easier off the ground, but sumo is gonna be easier to lock out. And that's only because with sumo, you're only going from here to here, whereas conventional, going all the way down here, your hips are all the way back here and coming up and in. So it's a lot more glutes involved rather than the sumo, where sumo does have glutes involved, but you don't have to go as far and they're not coming from as far back of a space. Is one easier than the other is a common question. That's all based on the person. So I like conventional better. I train it more, so I'm better at it, and I can get higher numbers with conventional than I can sumo. So if you practice one more, obviously you're gonna be better at one rather than the other. Anything else with sumo? That's pretty much it. One thing I do wanna mention that I know I mentioned already a bunch of times is pulling the slack out of the bar. That is a number one tip, whether conventional or sumo. Because a lot of people, when they go, I'll show you real quick. They go here, they don't pull their butt down, they just yank. So you can already kind of hear that slack.
that's the slack in the bar. So once you go to pull and you don't pull that slack out, you're gonna get the slack and then the weight is actually gonna yank you. You go here, it's gonna pull and jerk you.
So you wanna make sure that it doesn't jerk you and get that slack out of the bar so you can get enough power output from the ground, which is a deadlift. And that's gonna help you with your overall PRs, your overall strength and stuff like that, all right? So I don't know what video is gonna come next, we'll see. But all the social medias are gonna be down in the description below. I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Oh, another thing, Bradley Martin needs to stop stealing all my ideas. And if he gets a wrestling mat, I should issue a challenge to wrestle him off for his gym. And I'll win, so I should do that. All right, see you guys, peace.